You are turned on to Midwest Outdoors magazine. Since 1967, helping people enjoy the outdoors. Sponsored in part by Rapala Lures, Shakespeare Ugly Stick, America's strongest, most sensitive rod, Northwest Ontario, Canada, Abu Garcia, quality rods and reels for life. This week on Midwest Outdoors, summer fun at Crane Lake, Minnesota, and coverage of the 2014 Leech Lake Walleye Tournament. It all starts right here, right now.
Roger Cormier for Midwest Outdoors. Back in one of my favorite places to go fishing in northern Minnesota in Voyageurs National Park, Crane Lake. And you can see why right here. This is my first cast. We got a glorious day, flat, calm. And I'm fishing with one of my best friends, Scott Walsh from northern Minnesota. Get this bad boy in. Nice fish to start her out, Scott, huh?
Yeah, nice one. Real nice one.
Top water on a skitter pop. Not a giant, but a dandy. Ooh, she's buttoned up good. Look at that. Big smallmouth. We're gonna have a ball on today's segment, folks. We're talking fishing in northern Minnesota, Crane Lake. Stay tuned for some great action. This one showed himself, Scott.
Yeah?
Yep, feeding on minnows up there on the bank, right in the sand. Was just chasing bait. Minnows jumping out of the water. Fish was jumping out of the water. A lot of them are well done making little bass and are putting on the summer feed bag now. And you want to talk about a fun way to fish. Throwing topwater baits is one of the best ways to do it. We're hoping to catch bass a lot of different ways today. And I also want to talk about the great walleye fishing here in Crane Lake. But we're just getting rolling this morning. And as you can see, we're on a hot bite to start it out. And that's 14-pound Suffolk Siege right there. I like to use mono for my topwater. A lot of guys throw braided line nowadays, but I like that extra stretch. There we go.
There we go.
Boy, long distance hook set, huh?
He's way out there. I don't think he's real big, but come up and gave it a ride.
Oh, he's all right.
They're definitely got a preference for top water right now, but it doesn't seem the type of top water really matters a whole lot.
You know, calm days like today where we fish these gravel flats, shallow boulder and gravel fields where these fish are pulling up shallow. If it was a windier day, maybe cloudy conditions, you might fish off to the edges of points more, windblown spots, and we'd fish more with jerk baits, swimming grubs, inline spinners, and things that dive a little bit deeper. But today, it's these shallow gravel flats and shallow shorelines that are producing all these topwater strikes.
So they haven't really felt to me, it just keeps running at me. I always slowed down a little bit. The old skitter walk. Skitter walk holding its own.
I want that lure back when you're done with it.
Not a chance.
To take a minute here and talk about the Crane Lake area and what a great family and fisherman destination it really is. There's something to see and do here for every outdoor interest. Whether you're on a budget or you want to go more upscale, there's a lodge or resort that can take care of you. There's budget operations where you can go and stay on a cabin on the shores of Crane Lake, or you can stay at a more upscale property where you've got American plan dining, restaurants, lots of great places to eat here in town. There's some great local shops. There's a marina. If you bring your own boat and you've got any boat issues, they'll certainly be happy to take care of you there. Spectacular scenery here in Crane Lake as well. Really a chain of lakes that you can fish. Crane Lake, Sandpoint Lake, and Namekin Lake on the Minnesota-Canada boundary waters. And you can choose to spend your entire vacation just fishing in U.S. waters, or if you've got a passport and the proper paperwork, you can cross by water and fish the Canadian waters as well. There is a Canadian customs operation and U.S. customs operation based here in the Crane Lake area. So something to see and do for every type of outdoor interest in Crane Lake and a spectacular fishing destination, as Scott and I are showing you today. Yeah, you know, that scatter wrap's got a got a real unique action. It's got that scatter lip on it, and it's got a real wide wobble, evasive action side to side, and you know, more closely imitates a baitfish that's trying to flee a predator. You caught the predator.
Yeah, it's one of my favorite ways to catch smallie early in the year. Pre-spawn, right up through post-spawn is shallow cranks, and all my all-time favorites is probably a storm wigglewort made by Rapala, and now this new scatter wrap is one more little weapon in the arsenal.
We're actually motoring down the lake to another spot, and they're blowing up the surface in front of us here, and you see that a lot up in Crane Lake.
Got yours? I got mine.
Here we go. Another double header. They're two at a time up here on top of the reef. This reef tops out in 8 feet of water, and this gives you an idea how world-class this is. Unbelievable. Just nice quality bass loading up on the reef. And that gives you an idea what Crane Lake is all about right there, coming to the boat two at a time.
There's a pile of fish right there.
Yeah. Now, you fish all over northern Minnesota, but I know you love Crane Lake.
This is still one of my favorite places to come and fish big smallmouth, especially in the spring.
Folks, you can make Crane Lake a favorite spot for you to go fishing in, too. If you go to the website on your screen, CraneLakeTV.com, or give them a call at the 800 number. They're going to send you out a packet of information, give you everything you need to know about vacationing in Crane Lake, Minnesota. Folks, with Scott Walsh, one of the best friends, I'm Roger Cormier. We'll be right back with more Midwest Outdoors. Let's keep fishing, bud.
We'll send you another one right now.
Looking for your window to the outdoors? We have you covered with a Midwest Outdoors magazine subscription. Call now, 1-800-606-FISH, and for the low price of only $14.95, you receive 12 big issues of Midwest Outdoors magazine. Every month, Midwest Outdoors sends you the ultimate fishing and hunting guide to the outdoors. Call 1-800-606-FISH or visit MidwestOutdoors.com to get your ultimate guide to the outdoors. If you don't have one, you need one.
Hi, welcome to Midwest Outdoors here at the 6th Annual Leech Lake Walleye Tournament. I'm Dana Pitt with the Leech Lake Tourism Bureau. Behind me are over 150 boats ready to hit the water for some action. The weather forecast sounds nasty, but the fish forecast sounds good. Stay tuned as we follow the action. Well, the boats have only been out for about a half an hour now. We've already got one boat into the dock here with a big fish. Let's see what they got. Well, it's not even 8 o'clock, it's less than an hour into the tournament. These guys have got their big fish. It went about 5.25 pounds. Now they've got all day to go back out and try to get the rest of their slot fish. We're out on the main lake right now. We're kind of in a shallow water type area. There's a lot of boats kind of scattered up this shoreline. Seems like everybody's struggling. We've only seen a couple of nets out so far. It was a good bite here earlier in the week, but we had a strong wind blowing from the easterly direction for several days in a row, which made for a better bite. Today we've got a little bit different weather conditions, and teams are struggling to adjust. This team behind me just caught a real nice 21-inch fish that they had to throw back. They've got 5 in the box, and they're gonna head out pretty soon to look for that big fish. For years, Leech Lake had a slot limit of 18 to 26. All fish in that range had to be thrown back. The tournament rules allow for 6 fish per team per day to be weighed with one over 26 inches. That game has changed a little bit this year. Due to a bigger population of big fish in the lake, they've lightened up the slot to 20 to 26 inches. That 2-inch slot difference might not seem like much, but there can be some big weight differences in getting 18 inches versus 20 inches. So those big fish are not quite as critical anymore. If you can get 6 that are real close to 20, you're still gonna have some good weight. The fish seem to be really scattered in shallow water right now. They're mainly on shoreline structure. 3 weeks ago, there was still some ice floating around the lake, but in the last couple of weeks, it's been really hot, and the water's warmed up almost 30 degrees. It's about 70 degree water right now. There is a couple of teams here behind us that have got 5 in the boat, and another one's got 6 in the boat. They've got some big fish. So there are some teams that are putting things together. It'll be interesting to see in the weigh-in how things turn out. Well, it's only about 45 minutes before weigh-in, and we're just a mile or two from the weigh-in site. We've got a number of tournament boats right here close by. They're fishing some deep water in Walker Bay. They're rigging big minnows. They're looking for that big fish over 26 inches. Kind of swinging for the fences here in the final minutes of the day. It's been kind of a tough bite overall. Last night we had some severe thunderstorms, some heavy rain, which kind of shut down the bite a little bit. But somebody always figures it out and puts together a good plan. Let's go see who did it.
$12.67,
$15.52,
$14.26, way to go. The Leech Lake Tournament wants to make sure everything is legal here, so every fish that comes across the stage is first brought over to this bump board, and they make sure that everything meets the requirements. It has to be 14 inches long, and of course it can't be in the 20 to 26 inch slot. So anything that's close, they measure it, make sure everything's good. They also check to make sure all the fish are alive. If you've got a dead fish, it's a 0.3 pound penalty on it. There's a nice fish right there. Just makes it. Every fish is checked to make sure everything's legal.
Leech Lake Walleye Tournament, this is our sixth year, and over the last 5 years, we've been able to give out over $50,000 to local nonprofits. This year, our beneficiaries are Calvary Churches, United Youth Ministries, and Emmanuel Lutheran School. And we couldn't do any of this without the great support of our sponsors like Northern Lights Casino and Hotel, Leech Lake Tourism Bureau, Reed's Family Outdoor Outfitters, Northland Tackle, and there are many, many other fine sponsors that make this tournament possible.
$5.46 on the big fish. $14.54.
Well, day one of the Leech Lake Walleye Tournament is wrapped up, and although some people struggled today with the weather change and that, obviously Leech Lake kicked out a lot of fish today. Team number 94 had over 16 pounds of fish, and right over here, team number 99 had over 15 pounds of fish, less than a pound apart. And in fact, there's over 30 boats that are within 5 pounds of the lead, so it's anybody's game tomorrow. Stay tuned and see what happens tomorrow for the conclusion of Leech Lake Walleye Tournament. Stay tuned for more Midwest Outdoors.
Hey folks, welcome back to day two of the Leech Lake Walleye Tournament. And 157 boats are competing for over $41,000 in prizes. You can feel the excitement in the air. We're gonna see some good bags today.
Didn't even have time to get situated and that one was on.
We pulled up to our big fish spot. We put the lines down. It wasn't 5 minutes and she was on.
746.
Yeah, we got to go out and add something to that. Now, you know, yesterday we only caught five and they were smaller fish. So with that one, if we can get some 18, 19s today, maybe we can get the comeback award.
We got six fish of the morning already. So it was nice to get the big one out of the way.
583.
It's about 10:30 in the morning. We just got out here and checked our first boat. Over here is our local team of Brad and Austin Machad. They had a pretty good bag yesterday at just under 13 pounds, not too far off the lead. We checked with them, they've got five in the box already, just upgraded another one. They're looking for that big fish. So far, so good. It looks like it's gonna be a great day. Behind me are our local team of Mark Christensen and Harv Luck. They won this tournament about 3 or 4 years ago, so they know the lake, they know how to fish it, they know how to fish this tournament well. They had a pretty good day yesterday. They were just under 12 pounds. They've got three in the box right now. They said it's a little bit slower today, but it's still early, so they've got some time to add to the box and maybe get a big fish. They should be in good shape this afternoon. After another big rainfall last night, the lake is laying down really flat, calm, which generally means tough conditions on this lake. This lake, the bite tends to get better when the wind blows. But that's not true for everybody. Behind us is the team in second place, Jeff Woodruff and Gene Troina. They had just over 15 pounds yesterday, a little under a pound off the lead. They've got six fish in the box already, but they don't have that big one. They said they're running a little bit smaller fish today, but they are getting a lot of fish. They're getting some fish up in the slot. They just need that one real big one, and they're going to be right up there in the top. One of the really cool things about Leech Lake is the variety of water you can fish. We've seen people today fishing 20 to 30 feet rigging deep. We've seen 6 feet in cabbage weeds. And right here, we've got a lot of tournament boats fishing shallow water, boulders, and rock areas. Most of them are jigging with shiners, and everybody seems to be catching fish. A lot of people are upgrading. There's a few big fish being caught, and just a lot of fish in the slot in that 20 to 26 inch range, which doesn't do the tournament angler any good, but for the average angler coming up, they're a blast to catch. It's getting close to weigh-in time. We're just a little bit outside of tournament headquarters, and once again, there's a lot of boats out trying to swing for the fences and get that last big fish of the day. There's also a few boats here that have their fish, and they're just biding their time waiting to weigh in. From our trip around the lake today, it looked like everybody got fish. It was a tight race this morning when we left the dock, so it's gonna be really interesting to see which team put it all together.
Four, 7-7 on the big fish.
8-8-3.
8-8-3.
Eight even.
5-9-1. 5-9-1.
Ten five six. What was the bait of choice?
We jigged the middle both days.
Both days.
Yeah.
13-2-6. 13-2-6.
The Leech Lake Tournament Committee takes releasing fish very seriously. They do their best to keep the fish cool, to pump fresh water on them, to get them released back in the lake as soon as possible. Over the past 5 years of the tournament, the release rate has been over 90%. That means more fish back in the lake for you to come and catch.
This year there were 1,213 walleyes weighed in, average of 1.69 pounds. Our grand champion this year, with our largest winnings ever as far as a first place payout of $13,400, with a total weight of 27.94 pounds, is Haas and Leggett. $13,400, way to go. Let's give a big hand to our champions.
Well, that's a wrap of the 2014 Leech Lake Walleye Tournament. It was another great tournament with a lot of fish caught. In fact, over 1,200 fish were registered here at the state weigh stations. Congratulations to John Haas and Ray Legat as the winners of this year's tournament. Great tournament, guys. If you want to get in this tournament in the future, registration opens January 1st, and it usually closes around the 1st of March. For more information on this tournament and the Leech Lake area, check out the website at the bottom of the screen. Remember, walleyes are not the only fish in this lake. There's bass, panfish, muskies, pike, you name it. If you like to fish, this is the lake for you. And we've also got fine dining, shopping, everything in the town of Walker here you might need, and nearly 30 resorts and hotels around the lake for you to stay at. I'm Dana Pitt with the Leech Lake Tourism Bureau. Stay tuned for more Midwest Outdoors.
Looking for your window to the outdoors? We have you covered with a Midwest Outdoors magazine subscription. Call now 1-800-606-FISH, and for the low price of only $14.95, you receive 12 big issues of Midwest Outdoors magazine. Every month, Midwest Outdoors sends you the ultimate fishing and hunting guide to the outdoors. Call 1-800-606-FISH or visit MidwestOutdoors.com to get your ultimate guide to the outdoors. If you don't have one, you need one.
You know, we've been telling you for years to make sure you wear polarized sunglasses on the water. It cuts the glare, you can see the fish, and it keeps your eyes protected. But on a day like this, when it's overcast, These smoke lenses that I picked up earlier this morning, just not the thing, the best pair to be wearing. In fact, right now, what I'd do is I'd reach for an amber pair of glasses. It's gonna cut that glare just the same as the smoke lens does, but it's the contrast with this amber lens is gonna let you see into the water better than the smoke ever would. So under gray, dark conditions, switch to an amber. You know, at Berkeley, we have a full line of sunglasses from amber to the dark grays and everything in between for every condition on the water. It's gonna help you catch more fish. I'm Chris Hockley with Berkeley Fishing. This has been your Midwest Outdoors Tip of the Week.
For those fishermen who like to find structure or schools of fish on their sonar, the HDS Gen 3 unit has the ability to track back in sonar history, put the crosshairs on that location, and now with our smart steer control of the motor guide trolling motor, have the ability to have the trolling motor automatically take us back to that location. I don't have to build a route, I don't have to set a waypoint, I just touch the screen where I want to go, hit go to cursor, and the motor takes me there. This is Jeremiah Clark with Lowrance Electronics and the Midwest Outdoor Tip of the Week.
Hey folks, Mike Iaconelli here. I want you to check out the April issue of Midwest Outdoors. Big article on me in there. And you know what? You're gonna find out stuff about me and fishing that I didn't even know. See you soon.